All right, well, this is Adam Gussow. As most of you know, I've got a lot of videos of harmonica playing and harmonica teaching up on YouTube. Don't know how long YouTube will let them stay there, but I'm going to let them hang out in the wind. As many of you know, I recently gave up my harmonica ministry with a final video, thanks to my good friend, dear friend, Jason Ritchie. So what am I doing here? This obviously is not the same set of videos. Obviously, I mean, I've taught everything I know. I'm going to show you one new thing, actually, it occurred to me that a couple of things that I had not actually shown in the first go-round. So the blues is about repetition and with variation. Blues Harmonica Secrets Revealed is how this all started, so maybe I'll do Blues Harmonica Secrets Concealed, or maybe I'll just forget about secrets. Blues Harmonica Revealed. Maybe I'll hide myself in a balloon and get lost somewhere high in the winds above Colorado. I really don't know. Anyway, I don't believe in publicity stunts. What I want to do, let me just play a little music for you. I haven't really played in 2 weeks. My stuff's really rough. So when I first pick up a harp after 2 weeks, what I want to do is just kind of make it sound good. I try to turn off my brain. I don't worry about whether I'm being original or not. I just want to play some deep, basic, down the middle of the road stuff. Maybe a groove is nice too. I do whatever I want. That's the point. I do whatever I want. And if I don't play 12 bars, if it's 13 and a half, I'm okay with that too. I should practice more. I would be better than I am. But, you know, I got a life. Okay, here's the new thing I want to show you. I got an A harp. Interestingly enough, this is one that needs tuning. I played this on the street at the King Biscuit Blues Festival. Excuse me, the Arkansas Blues and Heritage Festival a couple of weeks ago. Now, check it out. The way to tell that it's out of tune, it's not obvious at first. Certainly if you play single note, it's not... It's the four draw. If I play the 1/4 octave, it's not really obvious, but if I play the 4/8 octave, whoa, well, it's my four draw. I'm pretty sure. It's pretty out. Now, my teacher, Nat Riddles, he didn't care at all about, I mean, if a harp was out, it was out, you know? And if you're playing with a band and you're playing hard, that's old school, right? I mean, in the new school, everybody has to always be in tune all the time. We've got to file our harps up. Okay, so I can take off the cover plate, and I did this many moons ago to show you what I do. I could file a little bit of brass off the tip of that four-draw reed. And then if I played... Well, that's pretty far out, isn't it? But I'm going to take another A harp. Let's just see. See if we can hear it. Okay, so here's the four-draw that I think is flat. Here's a new harp. Yeah. So there's the 4/8 draw when the 4 draw is not flat. You hear that? You get one big note. Now if I do it when it's flat, wow. How do I know it's not the 8 draw? Well, I don't think it is. How about the 1-4? Now, if I play the 1-4 draw octave and I pull harder, what you'll hear, I think, is that the 4 draw tends to go a little flat. Well, I cheated. I used my corner of my mouth. Okay, here's what I want to show you. And I'm going to show you, for the purposes of this, on a harp that has this flat note. Upper octaves, okay? Octaves on the upper part of the harp. Very important part of my style. They're one more way in which you have to remember that the harp has more than holes 2 through 6 or 1 through 5. A lot of harp players I know kind of just sit down there on the lower part. They never even go to the 6th blow. One of the most useful licks you have. Okay, so I'm going to go up and I'm going to do octaves. Well, why don't I octavize the following melody? Right? Now that's just sort of a boogie-woogie line. But if I go... except for that one... actually, the 3-7 and the 4-8 draw are both a little bit out, but then the 5-9 draw. Okay, so let me back up a little bit. When you tongue block on the upper octaves, you have to, in many cases, you have to block 3 holes, not 2 holes. This leads to a really weird kind of technique. I'm not convinced that I'm doing it right. I'm kind of, my lip is actually, I'm kind of biting my lip. It's not like that kind of tongue blocking, 1-4 draw, where my teeth are against the harp, and my tongue is touching the piece of wood between 2 and 3. No, when I'm doing 4-8, I'm blocking out 5, 6, and 7 draw. Well, you've got to find it for yourself. What I'll tell you is that it's great stuff to practice. The interesting thing is that when I go for that 4-8 blow, it's not actually 4-8, wait a minute. It's 5-8 blow, so I'm only blocking out 2 holes there. So you've got to alternate between blocking 2 and blocking 3, right? That's 3-6 blow, so I'm blocking 4 and 5, 2 holes. That's 3-7 draw, so from 3-6 blow to 3-7 draw. If you haven't done any of this stuff, that's where I would start. Let me try it with a harp, an A harp that doesn't have any flat notes. A little sloppy. So this is how you're going to use it. And actually, that the problem is that harp's not very good, right? You're going to use it like this. That's one way to do it, is a sort of repeated boogie-woogie type lick, and I'm actually going to run out of time fairly soon. Okay. The other way, though, is to use it as part of your soloing. So I'll play some stuff like that. And what I did was octavize this melody. You see how big and powerful a sound it gives you, especially on the lower harps. It really, OK, okay, and I can see I'm running out of time. I'm getting all this on off. My battery's running out. Okay, I gotta go. I might not be back. Then again, I might. I'll see you around. Bye. Maybe. I might not, though.